Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another Zoliki Silius here on the channel. Today, we're going to be returning as Johanna and our team today. We got Thrall, Diablo, Johanna, Zagara, and Tychus taking on Tyrael, Falstad, Thrall, Johanna, and as Bro Duncan stands. So, with Johanna Week, still celebrating the release of the newest hero to arrive in Heroes of the Storm, along with the public release of Heroes of the Storm in total. Don't forget about the Mayhem Begins event going on in Los Angeles this Saturday. I think it's... I'm not actually sure when this video... This video may actually go up the day of the event. If that is true... Because this was recorded like almost a full week before the event. But if that's true, then definitely check it out on the YouTube channel of Heroes of the Storm happening at, I believe, 1 p.m. Pacific time. I'll be playing with Team Low Expectations, defending the BlizzCon crown against the team that we actually don't know who we're playing against yet. I'm going to be going for a little bit more of a damagey build, but also want to make sure that I maintain my tankiness. And I'm a big fan of Righteous Smash. So what Righteous Smash is, basically it allows me to... It allows me to keep Punish up on as many targets as possible because it allows me to spam my abilities thanks to the fact that it returns mana. Now, one thing I love about Johanna is the fact that she is not really, I would say, as self-reliant as some other healers or some other warriors may be. Like with Arthas, for example, Arthas can keep himself alive pretty much as he wants. But the nice thing about my Arthas build, my standard Arthas build anyway, is... I enjoy Frostborn Hunger's returning a lot of mana in for me. Like I enjoy the fact that I'm able to spam my abilities pretty much freely whenever I want, thanks to the extra mana that I get from having Frostborn Hunger's. And on top of that, you have the self-healing of Rune Tap, you have Death Coil, etc., etc. Now, obviously, Johanna does not have any self-healing if you don't spec her for it, but she can still be very, very survivable and not really have to go back at all. One of the things that I feel like I've been doing a little bit more often than usual is going back on Johanna. More so than other warriors, and that's just because right now I do feel that I have not really played her enough to warrant really me going in. I don't want to say try-hardy builds, but I haven't found the build that suits me quite yet on her, let's put it that way. But I'm getting there. That's what these videos are about. And again, I'm going to try not to go overboard with the Johanna content. I'm really enjoying playing her. Right now, I'd be hard-pressed to actually not play her, or to play her over Arthas. I certainly am not willing to do that, as Arthas is still pretty much my go-to warrior. I enjoy playing him a lot more than other warriors in total. You want to be a little bit careful here with Tyrael as well as Falstad on the prowl. There's our Diablo now galloping in on his Direwolf. I'm not going to go too crazy over here. I'm going to go for Laws of Hope. Laws of Hope does give me a little bit of that healing that I was just talking about. It allows me to have a little bit of passive health regen. On top of that, if I need a quick burst of healing, I'm able to give it to myself. Like I said, I do want to make sure that I'm able to keep myself up as much as possible. I mean, staying alive in lanes, getting XP, etc., etc. And back up here from Falstad, does have Thunderstorm raging. Looks like Azmodan decided to go to the top lane. He didn't want to play against good old Johanna here. So I'm going to use the Blinding Glare here of Shield Glare and get a little bit of extra damage. I'm going to be going, like I said, a little bit more of a survivalist build today, but I'm also going to try to be pushing out the damage with Johanna. Now, everyone knows that Johanna is not exactly banging out the deeps on the meters. However, she can be surprisingly damaging if you build her in a certain way. Right now, the early abilities that I have with the ability to regenerate mana, thanks to being able to spam Punish, plus the ability to heal myself, that's just setting me up for what this build really truly becomes, which is a very surprisingly damaging build. And right now, I'm trying just to not die here. Let's see if I can catch Thrall in Condemn, which I was able to do. We were able to take him out thanks to Tychus throwing out the Concussive Grenade here. I'm going to go tap the fountain real fast. So far, each team has lost one hero each. And I'm not in any position right now to really engage. Not yet, anyway. Somehow I missed the Shield Glare on Johanna. I'm not sure how that actually happened. It looked like I actually hit her, but apparently not. Apparently I was wrong. Here comes Thrall coming in. Thrall freshly resurrected and freshly healed. Trying to save Tychus. Did not happen. We might actually take down Johanna. Down goes Johanna. Where's my condemn, though? If I had condemn up, I would have been able to easily kill Tyrael here. I've got condemn rocking and rolling. There we go. There's the punish. See you later. Down goes Tyrael. I'm going to go ahead and shield myself thanks to Iron Skin, and we're going to easily be able to take them out. There you go. The fan of my graphics card is really loud right now. I'm not sure what's going on with that. I'm going to go for Sins Exposed. Sins Exposed is kind of my bread and butter for the damaging spec here. So what you want to do is you want to initiate with the Shield Glare. What that's going to do is that's going to debuff the targets that it hits, regardless if it's a hero or if it's enemy creep or mercenaries or yada, yada, yada. And that basically increases all damage dealt to that target. So again, you want to lead off. If not lead off, then definitely at some point cast Shield Glare. As that is going to increase the damage taken, the damage done to that target. Diablo unfortunately grabbed Falstad out of my punish. I was going to be able to slow him down. Unfortunately, I'm a little bit out of mana as well, but that's okay. We did a lot of damage. Whoa there, Tyrael, where are you going? Tyrael looking like he wants to use Angelic Wrath offensively here, and he is going to get the dunk on Zagara, which is a little bit funny. I'm going to tap the fountain real quick here. And again, the whole goal of punish is you want to make sure that you're basically that you're profiting in mana. If you don't profit in mana, you have to hit at least four targets in order to get a net gain from punish on the return of mana. Otherwise, it's not worth doing. So here comes Diablo. Oh man, Thrall, I think you done goofed. There's a Shield Glare right on top of Thrall. See you later. He was taking increased damage from me, Tychus, and Diablo. That is not damage you want to be inflicting, or you want to be receiving. Let's put it that way. Land the Shield Glare there. Unfortunately, I don't have enough mana to follow this up. Oh, just barely out of range. Thankfully, Tychus was able to get Tyrael with that. I'm going to take a little bit of damage from Angelic Wrath. Not that big of a deal. I'm going to go ahead and use my Laws of Hope. I do have... unfortunately, I was going to say I do have my Condemn ready to go. See if I can take Falstad in there, but did not happen. I'll go ahead and tank the damage here. Don't mind tanking the stun with Iron Skin, rather. And if we can trap Azwadan here, there's no way he's going to be able to get out of this. Shield Glare, blinding him, increasing the amount of damage that we can deal to him. There you go. So we are going to be the benefactors, taking as many of the seeds as possible. And I'm going to be going for Falling Sword. Falling Sword is basically, so far, my choice heroic ability for Johanna. Blessed Shield, we did some pretty good work with Blessed Shield in the last game, but I do feel that Falling Sword is just superior. Very, very good for initiation. I do lead there with the Blessed Shield, and again go straight to punish. You can use Falling Sword to get in and out of bad situations there. It wasn't really a good example of what I just did, but it is something that can happen. And again, thanks to Righteous Smash, I am able to return a pretty respectable amount of mana per punish here. It does look like our Garden Tear went up in the top lane. Let's see if we can help them out. Push that. Where's the Maw going? Maw landing on absolutely nobody. It's all right. So we're going to try to keep him honest here in the top lane. As the Tear is now going towards the mid lane. There is Johanna. I did lead off with the Shield Glare here. At least I thought I did anyway. She did pop Iron Skin, which means that she was not going to be able to be knocked back. And Tychus is going to get instantly destroyed by the enemy team. We really, really could have used Thrall here for this fight. Unfortunately, well, let's see what ultimate did Thrall take. Thrall ended up taking Sundering. Yeah, Sundering would have been nice. I would have been able to save Tychus on top of splicing the enemy team up and allowing us to section off some of them. Johanna's actually pretty low. There's the Sundering landing on top of Johanna. I'm going to go in. There's the Condemn. There's the Punish. Here comes the Falling Sword on top of somebody, anybody. Down they go. Almost able to kill Johanna. I'm actually surprised she was able to get away. Tyrael's actually also going to get away as well. That is unbelievable. Tyrael eventually did not... He was not able to get away. I cannot believe that Johanna lived through that, though. I'm going to go for Burning Rage. Burning Rage, a big part of this build, because it does allow me to deal passive damage to everything around me, including enemy heroes. If I had Burning Rage for that last fight, they definitely would not have been able to escape. Not that Burning Rage does a ton of damage, it deals constant damage, and that's the big thing. honestly stunned that Johanna lived through that. Even more stunned that I didn't outright kill Tyrael. We get our second death, our first death rather. Not too thrilled about that, but it's okay. It's not the end of the world. Tyrael uses judgment. Actually screwed over his own player there with the Thrall. Again, I just want to try to limit the progression here in the mid lane. I want to wait for Blessed Shield to come up. There's the marks. You do see they look like golden, basically golden swords on everybody that you marked. Azadan trying to do what he can to stop me from killing this Siege Giant. However, it didn't really work out all that well. Getting Siege is definitely a good call here. I'm going to go start tanking the big Shambler up top. There you go, I did land the Condemn on top of Thrall. I'm not going to be able to catch him, especially when he has Wind Fury up. Enemy Johanna is trying to get me with Condemn. I end up just walking right out of it. Tychus almost killed Thrall, actually. There you go. So here's the initiation. There's a nice job with the Maw laying on top of Johanna. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to go in there with the Falling Sword quite yet. So much damage. See you later. Down goes Tyrael. See if I can take down the other Johanna here. I was able to land Falling Sword on top of her. She did save her Ironhide to make sure I couldn't pull her away with Condemn, and unfortunately she is going to be able to escape. I'm not sure where Zagara and Tychus actually ultimately went off to. Like, I was able to land the Shield Glare on top of Azmodan, ends up pushing him over the edge. So we end up trading a 3-for-1 there. We are up by 2 levels now, 3 levels. There we go. I am going to go for Blessed Hammer. Blessed Hammer is a pretty big part of this as well, as the little hammer that spawns from using Condemn actually does a fair bit amount of damage. I'm going to Iron Skin this one here. There we go. So far, so good. Team Solo Q Mid, Silliness 9, LMQ, Copenhagen, Wolves, Toys R Us Station up by 2 levels. Go back over here real quick.
It is time to harvest. Bring my terror.
So Zagara looks like she is going to take the take control of the Garden Terror.
The sun dawns. My children must sleep.
Not sure what the rest of our team are doing down in the bottom.
Your terror is starting to wilt.
Okay, apparently Zagara is not going to take it. I guess I will go take it, considering that I don't do a whole lot of damage. Or Tychus will get it. That's fine, too.
The terror shall uproot your enemies.
I mean, Tychus is one of our assassins, but that's all right. It's not that big of a deal. So the terror is going to go in the mid lane, the only lane that has a fort left. We're going to try to stop Thrall. There you go, I land the Shield Glare, instantly catch up to him with Condemn. And you see the amount of slowing that I'm able to land with Punish here. I'm going to see if I can land on top of Thrall. Actually missed him. Surprising that Thrall still has that much movement speed. Oh, another Whiff Maw from Zagara. And Thrall is going to eventually be able just to walk away, which is kind of annoying because he was definitely dead. Apparently we already lost our terror too. We actually lost ground in the mid. Not exactly sure how that happened. So we were too busy chasing Thrall. Unfortunately Zagara missed the Maw, but that's alright. Down goes Thrall, down goes Tychus, down goes Diablo probably as well. And there's not much that we're going to be able to do to stop our middle four from going down. I honestly have no idea what happened to our terror, but doesn't look like it was used in any sort of a constructive way, let's put it that way. So it's coming down to me and Zagara so far. I was able to land the Condemn. I don't know what the enemy team's Johanna was doing, but I'm just going to get an easy peasy kill on her. I do not have Falling Sword up yet, but if I do, I will easily be able to kill Azmodan at least. So if they're going to go for our Night Camp, we definitely need to defend that. So far, so good. Again, decent amount of damage. It's nothing too spectacular coming out of Johanna. It's respectable, though. There you go. So I land the shield glare, go right into condemn, and then straight into punish. Let's see if we can actually catch Tyrael this time around. This time I was able to land it on top of Tyrael. There you go. Nice job by Zagara. I'm not even going to worry about using Iron Skin there. And we should definitely take out our Night Camp while we have a chance. Kind of did the combo out of order there. Definitely my fault. You want to be leading with Shield Glare, or at least starting your precasting your Condemn. So when it hits, you already have Shield Glare debuffing everyone around you.
The night comes, heroes. Remember, kill the Shambles and claim this. Yes.
So far, the enemy team is in a pretty bad position here. I am able to catch Falstad with Condemn, or with Punish, rather. Maul ends up killing... The Maul actually ended up killing Thrall. I did see Asmodan over here. I definitely do not want to let him get away. Yeah, here comes Diablo to help me out. We do have our level 20s, which is always great. I am going to go for Indestructible. Indestructible, very, very good indeed. I've been doing some experimentation with Indestructible. And come to find out, Indestructible is pretty darn good. The extra damage you get out of Falling Sword is nice, but having a second life is definitely crucial. And then if you have the second life coupled with the fact that you have Laws of Hope, you can actually stay alive for a respectable amount of time. Yeah, the Roach is going to be tanking a little bit from the Garden Shambler here. Definitely want to make sure that I'm the one controlling the terror this time around. No offense to our Tychus player, but I'm not sure what happened to our first terror. So I'm going to do my due diligence here and do all that I can to keep it alive. So Diablo's going to run away from Tyrael and Johanna. I'm going to go right down the gut. Here, so they do have three people up in the top lane, no one down bottom except for Thrall, who's all the way back in their base. Diablo calling a preemptive GG. Apparently, us being up by one level and in firm control of all the map is not enough to stop that guy. It's all right. I'm back off away from Johanna here. The enemy team is just going to chase me down. And that's fine. So we pretty much have to wait for Thrall, at least. Diablo doesn't really matter, but we need Thrall to be there. See if I can hide the Polymorph Seed in there. There's Demonic Infestation coming down here. Demonic Invasion, rather. Nice job by Zagara pre-casting that Maw, going right into a Polymorph Seed. So we are able to take down Thrall. Unfortunately, we did lose Tychus. Falstad barely able to get away from that. That's right. Enemy team forgot that Johanna can actually still deal damage. Gonna land the Falling Sword on top of Asmodan, slow him down with Punish, and down goes Asmodan. Zagara ended up dying to, I think, Tyrael and Johanna. This condemned just barely. I'm gonna see if I can... Well, I'm waiting for Falstad now to come back. There he is. Falstad is our go-to target. Nice Shadow Charge there by Diablo. I've got to wait for my Shield Glare. There we go. There's Punish. Here comes Condemn right into the Lightning, doing extra damage to everything that it touches. Tyrael is going to run right into Thrall. He's going to get taken down. And we end up turning that one around very nicely. Enemy team does not have 100 seeds yet. I'm going to go up there and see if we can get our last 18 seeds.
Yes.
I really, really don't like being dismounted by a neutral creep. Not even neutral creep, but any creep, period. I think it's a little bit silly. Enemy team's Johanna is right there. So So definitely gonna go after Thrall here. He is our main target. Tychus is gonna get dunked by the Sundering. Not really worried about dying to Johanna as so much as I'm worried about Thrall here. So there you go, I do land the combo, but unfortunately Diablo saved Johanna out of it. And there's Falling Sword, I didn't even have to use it on Thrall. There's another Whiff Maw coming out from Zagara. So we don't have enough Siege. The enemy team was able to get enough Siege for their Terror. I don't actually know which heroic the enemy team's Johanna has. Just gonna mark the Shambler real quick, and Zagara's gonna end up putting them down.
It's over for now.
Thrall, I don't know where Thrall was.
The infested will return again.
There we go. So far, so good. We're able to keep up with the enemy team.
Your enemy has spawned a
gonna go ahead and grab the next Terror. The enemy team does have their own Terror. This time I'm gonna take this on the opposite end of the lane that the enemy team's Terror is going to do. Basically, what I'm trying to do with this positioning is I'm trying to force the enemy team to come to us. We want to make them be the ones to make the adjustment, not vice versa. And since we seem to have a little bit of a leg up in the team fighting, thanks to Zagara and Diablo, we should be able to successfully do that. If anything, I can at least get them away from defending their Terror because they're attacking me, and that's fine. So there's Thrall immediately. Yeah, you know, I'm just going to drop the Polymorph right underneath the Wild Growth. Apparently I didn't kill that last turret, which is surprising to me. I'm just going to get away, see you later. No problem at all. That's another reason why I like Falling Sword, is because I do have that ability to kind of create a little bit of safety for myself, although Falstaff barrel rolling after me is kind of annoying. I'm trying to hit Iron Skin here. I was able to get it. Save me, Diablo. Save me. Where are you going, Johanna? There we go. All right. Indestructible did save my life there. It was unfortunate that Falstaff was able, or I mean, Falstaff was in position to basically barrel roll after me, but I did get saved by Indestructible. That's exactly what it's supposed to do. And I'll just get right back into the fight here. Anyway, the reason why I like Falling Sword is because I am able to create an opening for myself to get away. I did use Blinding Shield on top of Johanna here. It's a charge coming from Diablo. Waiting for a Blinding Shield. I'm going to pre-cast my Condemn. There we go! That's the damage that I'm talking about. As long as you have an extra set of DPSers with you, even just one DPS, that's going to be enough to allow you to insta-dunk anything that you're able to capture with your Shield Glare Condemn combo. Again, that debuff is no joke that Shield Glare does provide. An extra 168 damage at this level is pretty devastating. But again, it's not about Johanna necessarily dealing that damage. It's about getting your team able to deal that damage. Condemn's very, very good with the Blessed Hammer, able to clear a lot of creep simultaneously, along with pulling them and grouping them together so we can get as much of them down as possible, as quickly as possible as well. See if we can start a fight down here in the bot lane, or in the mid lane, I should say. Not really trying to initiate here, though Tychus seems to think that I was trying to. That's okay. And we're back again. So very, very long game so far in this one. Recast Condemn, cast Shield Glare, go right into Punish. That is the Wombo combo. So again, it's Condemn, Shield Glare, Punish. You can do that for pretty much anybody. I'm going to eat this stun here just so I can keep up the DPS with Burning Rage. So there's the enemy team's Johanna. This time our Zagara actually did hit the Maw. Good job, Zagara. There's Sundering there coming in from our Thrall. Zagara definitely should have gone back, though. Yeah, I do have Indestructible back up, so I do have an extra life here. Let's see if I can land on top of Johanna. Not able to land on top of her again. Just barely getting out of range. See if I can back up here. I do not want to get stuck by the Condemn. So, Iron Skin able to save me there. Unfortunately, there is no fountain. Honestly shocked that Johanna was not touched by Falling Sword again. But we did get it. We are going to be able to summon another Terror here, and this one is going to do buku damage. I prefer not one of our DPSers to take it, but that's alright. We're not going to be able to save the top fort here, but with Zagara and the Terror pushing in mid lane, should be able to distract them long enough to get something done. There you go, there's the combo again. I'm just simply going to walk out of here. It doesn't really matter if they stop me. They're not going to be able to kill me. You see how much damage I'm able to get on top of Johanna with Blessed Hammer? I'm telling you, man, it's no joke.
Yes. Keep pulverized.
I was almost able to kill Johanna. The only thing that saved her was Iron Skin. But again, the object there was not to kill them, but the actual object was to distract their attention away long enough for the Garden Terror that was destroying the middle lane. We were able to get the key. Very nice job there by our Thrall player. Still would have preferred that he let either Diablo or myself take it, but what can you do? The answer is, you can do anything you want. No sense getting mad about it. So just clearing the top lane, making sure that it's all nice and spick and span. Gonna help out our bottom lane here as Zagaro's taking a brunt of the damage. There we go. Once again, we're the benefactors of getting more pods than the enemy team. There's the Sundering. Actually, the Sundering was cast long enough to hit me. There's the counter Sundering. Sundering's going off everywhere here. I did cast a Falling Sword. I was able to land right on top of Asmodan, bringing him out of the fight. The Maw did, I think, catch Johanna and maybe Tyrael. And Tychus and the others just pieced out on us, okay. So there's that. What happened to... I'm not sure what happened to our team. Yeah, Tychus is straight up piecing out is not what we needed there. Tychus left the team fight to go after the mercenary camp, and he didn't even get the regen globe. It's all right. Whenever you got a new game, you're gonna have new players. But I cannot overemphasize how important it was that Tychus be there for that team fight. He was there at the start of it, but wasn't exactly there for the end of it. So we're gonna lose the middle keep. Thus getting rid of any advantage that we created thanks to the Garden Terror. And the enemy team has all four members of their team out besides Asmodan on our core. They could just end the game here. Yeah, here's Asmodan. So that's just going to be it. So, again, that's Heroes of the Storm. One bad decision can cost the game. Final total, 29-24. Again, we're going to do one more Johanna game and then switch it up. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time for more Solo Key Silliness. Until then, so long, everybody.